Hello friends, my name is Nisha and welcome to my channel. In this channel, I'll upload videos on a question and answer discussion of various civil engineering competitive exams like GATE, engineering service exam, SSC, RRB, PSC, etc. So if you are preparing for any of these exams, please do subscribe to my channel. And let's start today's session. Today I'll discuss a topic projectile from engineering mechanics. And this topic is commonly asked in many competitive exams. So it is a very important topic. Please do watch till the end. Let's start. Okay. So now, when we project a particle in an upward direction, not in a vertical up direction but in an inclined direction, when we project a particle, it will trace a path, a parabolic path, and then it will hit the ground at some other point other than the point where you have projected the particle, right? So this path, the path traced by the particle is known as trajectory, and the particle is known as projectile. Okay. And there are certain other terms also related to this. I'll explain one by one. And see, from A you have projected the particle and it hit the ground at B. So the distance between A and B, the horizontal distance between A and B, is known as horizontal range. Okay. And so at certain angle we have projected the particle. So that angle is known as, here I have denoted by alpha, it is known as angle of projection. And then a certain initial velocity I have projected the particle, that is u, here I have represented by u, and that is known as the initial velocity of projection. Okay. Now this it is inclined at an angle alpha with the horizontal, so its vertical component is u sine alpha and the horizontal component is u cos alpha. At any point in this trajectory, at any point, we can represent using two coordinates. That is, see, if the point is P, this y coordinate and this is the x coordinate. Any point we can represent it by. See, if the point is at P, A, it is 0, 0. If it is at B, the x coordinate will be R. Horizontal range is represented by R and the y coordinate will be 0, right? Any other point, we can say x, y, coordinate x, y. P, the P coordinate of P is x, y. Okay. Now, there are another important terms, that is known as maximum height. Maximum height is when the particle reaches the topmost point, that is the maximum height it can achieve. That is known as maximum height. And when the particle is in air, from after projecting from A and before hitting the ground B, the particle is in air. So, the time between projection and hitting of ground, that time lapse is known as time of flight. And there is one more, and horizontal range. Okay, these terms have some equations also, so that is very important to know. And I'll derive one by one, and I'll suggest you also should know the derivation, how to derive this. Always you can by heart these equations, but I suggest you to know how to derive these equations. Okay. I'll start with maximum height. Maximum height, you know, that is the maximum height when the particle reaches during this projectile. Okay. So height, maximum height. How can we find the maximum height? So before this, in linear motion, we have learned some linear motion. There are some equations, certain equations, which we will use in this topic also. That is final velocity v square minus initial velocity is equal to 2as. This is an equation from the linear motion. In case if you want me to upload a video on linear motion, please do let me know in the comment section below. And we are using this equation. Initial final velocity minus initial velocity is equal to 2a into s. Okay. Let's see how we can apply here. So when it reaches the maximum point, the peak of this trajectory, there will not be any vertical velocity, right? Vertical component of the velocity. There will not be any vertical component of the velocity. Only this horizontal component will be there. So, vertical component, velocity of vertical component will be 0. And the horizontal component will be 2 u square, u initial, no, sorry, initial velocity v u is equal to u sine alpha. Okay, u sine alpha, that is the vertical component, initial vertical component. Initial velocity is u, initial vertical component is u sine alpha. Final vertical component, when it reaches here, it will be zero. There will not, when it reaches here, there will not be any vertical velocity. So it's zero, and this is equal, the square is equal to, it says 2as. What is a? Is the acceleration. Acceleration due to gravity. When we project a particle upward direction, it is traveling against the gravity. Right? It is traveling against the gravity. When it travels against the gravity, the g value, a value, acceleration value will be minus. Here it is, a is g, acceleration due to gravity. So it is 2 into minus g into s. S we can represent, it is the maximum height, it is the distance, it is the maximum height it is traveling. Okay, s is replaced by h max. Now solving this, we have minus u square sine square alpha is equal to minus 2g h max. Solving this, we get h max is equal to u square, minus and minus both get cancelled, u square sine square alpha divided by 2g. This is the equation for the maximum height of projectile. And this question I have seen in Maharashtra PSC exam, preliminary exam. So last time this has been asked, this time could be time of flight or horizontal range also. Okay, so this is the equation for horizontal, maximum height. Next let us derive the time of flight. For time of flight also, we use an equation from linear motion, that is, we know s is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay, for time of flight also we use this equation, that is, see, now time of flight means from here it reaches this point. So any in between point, the y coordinate, this is the y coordinate. When it reaches here, this will be the y coordinate. When it reaches here, the y coordinate is 0. The y coordinate, when it the particle reaches here, the y coordinate 0, x coordinate will be r. Okay, now so here our y coordinate is 0, distance travel, y coordinate is 0, and then u is the initial velocity, that is u sine alpha, and t we will have to find out, plus half a is g minus g and t square. So let's zero here, rearrange this, u sine alpha t is equal to, this is minus, so it is equal to half g t square. 1t and 1t get cancelled, and then only 1t is here, t is equal to 2 u sine alpha divided by g. This is the equation for time of flight of projectile. Okay, now next is horizontal range. So this equation also is from linear motion. Okay, next is horizontal range, let's see that too. So horizontal range, so before that, we know velocity is equal to distance by time, distance traveled by time. Okay, so v is equal to distance traveled by time. Now we need to find the horizontal range, the distance. So distance is equal to v velocity into time, right? Now so here we want to see the horizontal velocity, because horizontal range we are calculating. So what is the horizontal component of this u? The horizontal component is u cos alpha. Vertical sine component was u sine alpha. The horizontal component is u cos alpha. So here applying u cos alpha into t. T time of flight, when it reaches b, the time of flight we have found out early, that is 2 u sine alpha by g. 2 u sine alpha by g. So here when we solve this, this is equal to 2 u square sin alpha cos alpha by g, right? Now 2 sine alpha cos alpha is equal to sine 2 alpha. We know sine 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta. So here also 2 sine alpha cos alpha is equal to sine 2 alpha. So this is equal to u square sine 2 alpha by g. That is equal to horizontal range. That is equal to horizontal range. So that is our maximum height, time of flight and horizontal range. Thanks for watching. If you have any comments, queries, please let me know in the comment section below. And thanks for watching. That's all for today. All the best for you.